Number 10, Neil Yakupov.
Richardson. Cassie. Julia clears it up. And suddenly driving in is Yakupov. Goes to the net, gets the goal. Yakupov just dropped the shoulder and drove.
And Luka Spiza can't connect with Zach Cassian. That's twice in that shift. Now Spiza's tired. No gap, no speed. Yakupov gets those big legs moving, takes him wide, and sells out trying to get to the net. And Ryan Miller, that looked a lot like the golden goal from Sidney Crosby as Miller thinking about poke check, and Yakupov slides it underneath him.
And I actually played for the Ducks for 3 years. Well, you with a long shot, and that is blocked. Good news for the Oilers. Matt Hendricks is back on the bench. Archibello is stopped, but Fane carries on. Fane with a shot that goes just like out in front. Yakupov scores! Neil Yakupov, without a goal in his last six games coming in, has given the Oilers a 2-0 lead.
Jason, Mark Fane makes this play happen because he's the defenseman jumping up.
Well, the Oilers have figured out they got to start getting pucks to net. It doesn't matter how hard the shot is. You look at this, caroms off the backboard, ends up Fane on the stick of Yakupov. Right place at the right time, but Yakupov's had a strong game so far. He's been all over the place.
But what does he do? He doesn't drift behind the net.
Started with an Archibello face-off win. Archibello, Perron, and Yakupov. Yakupov! Scores. Hard work sets it up from David Perron. Finished off by Neil Yakupov. It's a one-goal game. Gordon wins that draw. Here's a snapshot by Joel Stillock. Out of the net, they score. Yakupov in front. Stillock got tied up with Couture, and Yakupov is the beneficiary.
Winning the faceoff, so key. Right off the bat, win the faceoff, help it out, keep control of the puck, get the puck to the net quickly, and you see Justin Braun falls on Alex Stalock. And then it's quickly dug out. That's the really good play by Jordan Eberle. When you look at that again, Jordan Eberle digs that puck out after Justin Braun falls on Alex Stalock, kicks it out front quickly.
Back for Chicago. Patrick Sharp, down the middle he goes, gets around it, and back the other way comes Hall with Yakupov. Hall, Yakupov, in by themselves, Yakupov, backhand, he scores! Nair Yakupov! With a shot that snapped the stick of Andy Green, so Green without a stick. Eberle, Yakupov, this time, bingo! Nair Yakupov! A power play goal, the Oilers have the lead.
He is the first shooter for the Oilers.
Yakupov against Luongo. And Yakupov scores!
I like that choice by Todd Nelson. He knows that Neil Yakupov needs a little confidence booster, but he also knows that Neil Yakupov in this situation is one of the best that he's got on his team.
Now to Andrew Ferentz. Cross ice for Derek Roy. Roy moving in with Yakupov, cutting for the net, scores! Nail Yakupov! A five-game point streak. He ties the game at one.
Just like that, and wow, are we starting to see maybe the emergence of what everybody thought Nail Yakupov could be. Terrific breakout, Yakupov wide side. He gets his feet moving. Now he's going to take the shot towards the net. That's what you got to love. When you see a guy like Neil Yakupov and his speed, he comes up with timing. He wasn't going 100 miles an hour the whole time.
To Pakarinen. Pakarinen gets by Myers. Fires a shot. Hutchinson makes the save. Pouliot out in front. Yakupov scores. Neil Yakupov, second goal of the game. The Oilers have a 4-3 lead. What a pass from Benoit Pouliot.
And what a finish by Nail Yakupov. That wasted no time getting off Yakupov, sticking in the net. The entry into the zone. Another good one. Pakarainen just pushes the puck by, gets it towards the net. And then you've got to get the support down deep by Pouliot. It's just a beautiful pass and a beautiful finish. The key is, though, being active away from the puck to make sure you keep the control.
And stays loose, and the Bruins desperate to get it out, and they can't. Orders are buzzing here. Here's Klefbom. No lane to shoot. Banks it off the end board. Ryan Hamilton battling for position. Out front, Yakupov scores! And this guy is hot!
Teddy Purcell fires it in. Everly will be the first to get to it in the corner. Back to the point for Yakupov. Yakupov to Schultz. Back to Yakupov. Hammers a shot and he scores! Nail Yakupov pulls the trigger to make it a 3-2 game! Rocket power play goal for Nail Yakupov. His fourth power play goal of the season.
What do you say? Hadn't scored in six?
Hadn't scored in six games.
And Yurgen. Jump in entry. And now what you've got to do on a jump in entry, you got to outnumber. Now you've got two extra guys on the ice because it's 6-on-4. It's just a set up for a one-timer. That's all this is. Get the puck back. Touch it back. Big shot. Nice little jump there. Is that Benoit Pouliot? Comes across, jumps, that's got to throw off. That is no Teddy Purcell.
Schultz picks it up on the far side. Nugent Hopkins has it now. Slides it to Everly. Everly couldn't pull the trigger. Yakupov can, and he scores! Nail Yakupov! A power play goal! The Oilers ahead 4-3.
One of the first plays on this power play, one of the reasons this goal is happening is because Ryan Nugent Hopkins is much stronger on the puck. But work in towards the net. The lack of panic in Jordan Eberle is absolutely amazing. To keep the puck in, they're able to move it around. But as it comes down to Jordan Eberle, he's got a chance to maybe shoot it, force it here. Instead, between the legs, back to Yakupov. Thinking of that, Scott Hartnell talked to us today about how hard it was to get traded from Philadelphia. And it broke his heart until he got some tough love from his agent.
Nail Yakupov puts the Oilers in front. His 12th goal of the season. It's 3-2.
Nail Yakupov pumped up. There's a face-off win and a shot that goes wide and gets a generous bounce off the boards. Battle for the face-off. A nice play by Teddy Purcell coming across, coming around, making that pickup off the scramble draw. The shot goes wide. That's a shot that Oscar Klefbom is looking at. You can tell from his head he wants to put that off the end boards, and Nail Yakupov reads it perfectly. See where he's shooting? He's thinking wide right there. He's thinking that the puck's going to come back out.
On the last home game for the Edmonton Oilers is putting on a show so far, a period and a half in. Yakupov scores! Nail Yakupov!
It's another young defenseman, lost control of the puck on the boards, but Derek Roy gets the puck out to center. Bobbling the puck is Lyndon Bay. Roy's in a long, Yakupov scores! Brilliant pass from Derek Roy after a Vancouver turnover, and Ryan Miller is beaten for the first time, 1-0 Oilers.
Well, ever since Derek Roy came to the Edmonton Oilers, there was instant chemistry with Yakupov and he. And Yakupov, he almost knew that puck was coming. This is one for Lyndon Bay that got to get control of, lost it, then lost the battle. But what patience by Derek Roy. Hard to fault Ryan Miller on that one, but Yakupov, knowing that he's going to get the puck, just gets himself in ready mode. He's got his stick down, he's hunting the puck, got his knees bent, and makes no mistake. The early turnover gives the Oilers a 1-0 lead.